ശ്രീമതി ആർ പത്മാവതി, ഹെഡ് ഓഫ് ഡിപ്പാർട്ട്മെന്റ് ഇ സി ധനലക്ഷ്മി ശ്രീനിവാസൻ കോളേജ് ഓഫ് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് ആൻഡ് ടെക്നോളജി, ചെന്നൈ. ഷി പെർസ്യൂഡ് ഹർ ബാച്ചലർ ഓഫ് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് ഇൻ ഇലക്ട്രോണിക്സ് ആൻഡ് ഇൻസ്ട്രുമെന്റേഷൻ എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് അറ്റ് ദ നാഷണൽ എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് കോളേജ്, കോവിൽപ്പട്ടി. ഷി ദെൻ വെന്റ് ഓൺ ടു വർക്ക് ആസ് എ ടെക്നിക്കൽ എഡിറ്റർ ഇൻ ഡോമിക്സ് ടെക്നിക്കൽ ഇൻഫർമേഷൻ പ്രൈവറ്റ് ലിമിറ്റഡ്, ചെന്നൈ. ഷി ദെൻ പെർസ്യൂഡ് ഹർ മാസ്റ്റേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് ഇൻ അപ്ലൈഡ് ഇലക്ട്രോണിക്സ് അറ്റ് സത്യഭാമ യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റി, ചെന്നൈ. She is currently pursuing her PhD in Anna University, Chennai. She has published several national and international journals and has attended many conferences. Her areas of interest include linear integrated circuits, digital electronics, electronic circuits, VLSI design.
Welcome to UGC lecture series BSc Electronics Honors for the subject Analog Electronics. Today we are going to discuss junction field effect transistor, in short it is JFET, in which construction and VI characteristics of JFET and modes of JFET. There are three modes: common source, common gate and common drain. JFET, that is junction field effect transistor, is a three terminal device and its applications are wide in range. We have seen earlier about bipolar junction transistor, and today we are going to see field effect transistor. And what is the basic and very important difference between the bipolar junction transistor and field effect transistor is BJT is a current controlled device and FET is a voltage controlled device. So, why it is a current control and voltage control? When you recall, the output current of BJT, that is the collector current IC, is the direct function of the base current IB. It is the input current. The output current is depending upon the input current IB, and in FET the output current, the drain current, will be a function of the voltage gate source voltage VGS, which is applied at the input circuit. So this is the gate source voltage by which the ID current, the output current, is going to change. So in FET the output current depends upon the input voltage. So, it is a voltage controlled device. So, when you look at this table, these are the terminals of BJT, that is bipolar junction transistor. It has emitter, base and collector. In case of FET, again there are three terminals called source, gate and drain. So, the source is similar to the emitter in BJT. Similarly, gate is similar to base, and drain is similar to the collector. So, here in BJT we have learned that the emitter is going to emit the electrons through the base, and it is a common terminal, and the collector is collecting the electrons from the emitter. Similarly, the source, which is going to give you electrons, source of electrons, and so it is called a source, the terminal is called a source, from which the electrons move towards the drain. So, it is going to drain, the electrons are draining to the terminal called the drain terminal, and so it is drain terminal. Gate, we know that the FET is a voltage controlled device. So, the voltage applied to the gate terminal is going to control the current from the source to the drain. So, it is the gate terminal. It is going to be a gate wall for the electron flow between the source and the drain. When you look at this block diagram, this is the output current in BJT, the collector current, and the input current is the base current. It is a current controlled device, and here for the FET, the output current is the drain current, and the voltage applied to the input side is gate source voltage. This is the control voltage, which is going to control the current, output current ID. So, the bipolar transistor has emitter, base, collector. Field effect transistor has source, gate, drain. So, this picture shows the BJT as a current control device and FET as a voltage control device. So, this picture is going to give you the details about the basic construction of FET and the symbol of FET. So, when you look at this construction of FET, there are three terminals given as drain, for D for drain, G for gate and S for source. Here this is the N type material upon which the p-type material is formed. So these two p-type materials are connected, and which is again connected to the gate terminal through the metallic contact. And again here on the top of the n-type material there is a metallic contact through which this n-type material is connected to the terminal called drain. Similarly, at the bottom side of this channel, n channel, we have a metallic contact through which it is connected to a terminal called the source, and this is the n channel JFET, and we have a p channel JFET also. So instead of n material on the base on the substrate, we can have a p material on the substrate upon which these two n materials are formed, and these two n materials are interconnected, and through the metallic contact it is connected to the gate. So here in the BJT we have seen two configurations, namely NPN and PNP. In FET we have again two configurations, it is n channel FET and p channel FET. For the n channel FET, this is the symbol. So the difference between the n channel and the p channel in symbol is the arrow mark at the gate terminal and at the drain terminal. So here at the gate terminal the arrow is pointing towards the channel for n type material, and the drain current is also towards the FET. And here for p type p channel JFET, the arrow mark at the gate terminal is away from the channel, and it is also the drain current is also away from the FET. So this is the basic difference between n channel FET and p channel FET. So as we have discussed, there are two FETs, it is n channel and p channel, but in the case of BJT it is a NPN and PNP type of configurations. And BJT, we know that it is a bipolar device. Why it is called as bipolar? Because the conduction is both by the electrons as well as in the holes, but in the FET it is a unipolar device. Why it is unipolar means, in n channel FET the conduction is only by the electron, and in p channel FET it is only by the hole, whereas in the case of BJT it is by both the electrons and the holes, where whatever the configuration may be. In NPN the conduction is by electrons and holes, in PNP also the conduction is by electrons and holes, but in the case of FET, in n channel it is only by the electron, and is and in p channel it is only by the hole. So it is called as unipolar device. The FET has high input impedance, maybe around the several hundred mega ohms. It is far more than the input resistance of the BJT, but BJT is very has very high sensitivity over the changes in the applied signal. In other words, the variation in the output current is typically a great deal more for BJT than for FET. So the typical AC voltage gain for BJT amplifiers are a great deal more than FET. The field effect transistors are more temperature stable than BJTs, smaller in construction, so it is used in the integrated chip. It is normally used in the integrated chip, and there are two types of field effect transistors. One is junction field effect transistor, the other one is metal oxide semiconductor device. In metal oxide semiconductor device there are again two types. It is enhancement type and the depletion type, and in short the metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor is called as MOSFET, MOSFET. And the MOSFET transistor has become one of the most important device in design and construction of integrated circuits for digital computers. So these MOSFETs are very very useful in switching circuits. So this is the basic construction of JFET. So just now we have seen in the block diagram, so it is the n channel JFET, where the base is the n material upon which two p type materials are formed, and these two p type materials are interconnected through this metallic contact. And again there are three terminals. Through the metallic contacts we have the N substrate is connected to the drain through the metallic contact, and similarly the gate is connected, the p-type material is interconnected and given connected to the gate terminal through the metallic contact, and we have a metallic contact through which the n-type is connected to the source terminal. And can you imagine what is this layer? You can compare it with the diode or you can compare it with the BJT. Without any bias, we know that there is a small depletion region in the junction. So, without any bias, you can say it has two junctions, here PN and here NP. So, it has a smaller depletion region, and what is a depletion region? It has no moving charge, or it is a free of electrons or holes. So, there is no conduction now. So, what will happen if the voltage is given across the drain and source? Here, this is the drain terminal which is given positive polarity to positive polarity of the external battery, and negative terminal is given to the source. Here, so this voltage is called as VDD, or you can say the voltage between the drain across the terminals drain and source, VDS. And the condition is VGS is equal to 0 volt. So, make this VGS 0 and give only the drain source voltage and some positive voltage greater than 0. So, what will happen if VDS is given and VGS is 0? That is what you have to look around. Here we know that it is a n channel JFET. So, it is the n material, that is the channel is of n type. And this N material is given to the positive terminal of the external battery. So, what type of bias is this? It is the reverse bias condition. So, we know that if the reverse bias is given, if already exists depletion region, the width of the depletion region will increase if the reverse bias condition exists. And when you see the voltage to the source, and again it is the N type source. So, here it is given to the negative terminal of the external battery, and so the reverse bias voltage given to this source is very less when you compare it with the voltage given to the drain. So, the depletion region width, when you look at the lower part of the channel, is lower when you compare it with the upper part of the channel. Because this is because the channel resistance effect present in the n-type material. So, here you can imagine that the resistance present in the n-type channel and the resistances are equally distributed in the substrate or n-type material. And if you give 2 volts, and this is 2 volts is the drain source voltage. 2 volts is given here, consider this as the drain terminal, and if you give 2 volts here, and the resistances are equally distributed, and so across this resistance the voltage is 1.5. actually this 2 volts is equally divided across all the resistances. So, here 0.5 volt is dropped, and here another 0.5 volt, another 0.5 volt, and another 0.5 volt, and at last it is 0. So, here when you calculate the voltage, here it is 1.5, because 0.5 will be dropped over here, since the resistance is equally distributed, and across this resistance again another 0.5 will be dropped out. So, it is 1 volt, another resistance is there, another 0.5 will be dropped out, it is 0.5 volt. So, when you consider the voltage at this end, that is the upper end and the lower end, when you compare, the upper end have 1.5 volt and the lower end has 0.5 volt. So, the negative bias exists at the upper side of the channel is more than the voltage at the lower end, and so the width of the depletion region is wider in the upper side of the channel than the lower side of the channel. Here before applying this VDS voltage, this width of the depletion region at the lower end is the with this similar when you apply VDS now, because this voltage is smaller than this voltage, so it becomes wider. And what happens, we know that source is going to give you the electrons. So here negative terminal is connected to n-type material, and we know that in the n-type material the majority carriers are electrons, and here the electrons will move from the source to the drain, and that is what the current flow happens, electron flow happens. And here this is the conventional flow given in the diagram, so it is opposite to the electron flow. Conventional flow is opposite to the electron flow, and so it is marked opposite to the electron movement. And from this diagram we can say that the current, drain current, is equal to the source current. The same current will flow from the drain as well as to the source. So ID is equal to IS. And what happens, the resistance of the channel when the VDS is increased again. Here if the VDS is given and greater than 0, the resistance is increased here, because the depletion region with this increased, and so the channel is going to be very minimum when the depletion region is increased again. And the flow is also getting reduced, the electron flow is also getting reduced, so the resistance is increased now. And again if you increase the voltage VDS, what will happen to this channel? Imagine that this depletion region is going to be again wider and wider on both the sides, and it pinch off at one particular time, one particular point. So when you look at this circuit, these two depletion regions are touched each other, and this point is said to be pinch off point or pinch off voltage. The voltage VDS, when you the amount of voltage VDS is given, so that the depletion region with this increased on both the sides of the channel, and it gets pinched off, and so the channel is blocked here, and so the electron flow is also blocked. And at this point the resistance is very high, it is maximum, and it becomes infinite. And so the current is 0, and actually practically there exists a small channel, the path in the n channel, and due to which there is a current flow called IDSS. IDSS is the drain source current when this gate and source is shorted. If you see this diagram, the condition is VGS is equal to 0 and VDS is greater than 0. So first initial condition, VGS is equal to 0, in the sense we are shorting out the gate and the source here to establish this condition, VGS is equal to 0. And after which we are giving the voltage VDS across the terminals, drain and source, and if this voltage is increased beyond some value, the depletion region with this wider, getting wider and wider, and at one point, say it is a pinch off voltage. At the pinch of voltage, both the depletion region will touch each other or pinch off each other, and so there is a block in the channel, and so the electron flow is 0. But still practically there exists the current flow called IDSS in this path, and this IDSS is the saturation current beyond the voltage across the drain source terminal, beyond the pinch off voltage. If we increase the voltage across the drain and source terminal above the pinch off voltage also, there exists the current, and that current is said to be IDSS, and it is the saturation current. Everything is given in the graph also. The graph is plotted between the voltage, the drain source voltage, and the drain current. Drain source voltage across the x axis and drain current across along the y axis. So here this is the initial condition where there is no voltage given, and so the current is 0. There is no voltage given, the current is 0. So when the VDS voltage is given across the terminals, drain and source, the current is flowing. the current from the, so the electron will flow from the source to drain. And this, when you increase again and again the VDS voltage, the current flow is also increased, and at this part it is normally a straight line, it is equivalent to a straight line, and so the resistance is constant for these regions. And when VGS touches this VP, that is the pinch off voltage, or when the VGS is equal to this pinch off voltage, what happens to the channel, what happens to the depletion region? For this region, the depletion region with this slowly increased, and at VP the depletion region, the width of the depletion region pinched off, and so the channel is blocked. At this point the resistance of the channel is maximum, because if the channel blocked, then there is no electron flow, and so the channel width is very very maximum. And practically we can say that there exists a small channel path through which there is a flow of electron and flow of current also, and that current is said to be the drain source current. And this drain source current IDSS is given as the gate source terminal shorted, because the condition is VGS is equal to 0. So to make VGS 0, this condition, the gate and the source terminal shorted, so that we can say it is 0 volts between the source and the gate terminal. So beyond that, the pinch off voltage, if you increase the voltage across VDS, the same current, the maximum current is flowing in the channel, and it is known as IDSS, and this current is said to be the saturation current. And this part beyond this VP, this region is said to be the saturation region or constant current region, or you can say it is a linear region. In this region the FET can be used as an amplifier also, and you can say this is a current source, because after which if you increase the VDS voltage, the current is always constant. So you can use this JFET as a constant current source for because it has a saturated current output at its drain terminal. If VDS is increased to a level where it appears that two depletion regions would touch is referred to as pinch off, and the level of VDS that establishes this condition is referred to as pinch off voltage, and this is very important, this pinch off voltage. And ID maintains the saturation level defined as IDSS. In reality, a very small channel still exists with the current of very high density. ID does not drop off at pinch off and maintains the saturation level indicator. And why you call the FET as a current source? Because when VDS, if you increase beyond the VP, if you increase the drain source voltage beyond the pinch off voltage, then the JFET has a characteristics of current source. The current is fixed at ID equal to IDSS, and what is IDSS? It is derived from the drain to source current with the short circuit connection from gate to source. IDSS is the maximum drain current for a JFET, and is defined by the conditions VGS is equal to 0 volt and VDS is greater than VP. Why it is a modulus pinch off voltage is, this pinch off voltage is negative for N channel JFET and positive for P channel JFET. So whatever the channel may be, if the VDS is greater than the pinch off voltage and if VGS is equal to 0, then the JFET can be worked as a constant current source. And this is a diagram to depict the current source, JFET as the current source. Here if VDS is greater than V, the pinch off voltage, ID is equal to IDSS, that is the current at the drain terminal, the drain current is equivalent to the drain source current when the gate and the source is short circuited, and the condition is VDS greater than VP and VGS is equal to 0 volts. Okay, until now we have seen that VGS is 0, that is the gate source voltage is 0. and we have given only the drain source voltage, and if it is positive voltage, what happens to the channel and what happens to the depletion region at the channel, and how the current flow happens and what is the effect of the resistance in the channel. And now, if VGS is given to the circuit and if VGS is negative, that is less than 0, what happened to the channel, what happened to the end channel device? The voltage from the gate source, gate to source denoted as VGS is the current controlling voltage of the JFET. We have three terminals in the JFET, that is the drain, source and the gate. If one terminal is going to control the current flow between the two terminals, and what is the terminal which is going to control the current flow is the gate. Gate is going to control the electron flow from the source to the drain. And so, if the VGS voltage, and the FET is called as a voltage controlled device, and so the if the voltage is given across the gate and source, depending upon the value of the voltage, whether it is a negative or more negative or a positive voltage, the depending upon the value of the gate source voltage, the electron flow from the source to drain is going to be controlled. So, this VGS is the controlling voltage of the JFET. For the n channel device, the controlling voltage VGS is made more and more negative from its VGS is equal to 0 volt level. It is more negative for n channel FET. In other words, the gate terminal will be set at lower and lower potential levels as compared to the source. So, if the source voltage is say it is 1 volt, then this gate terminal must be lower and lower than this 1 volt, say it is minus 1 or minus 2 or minus 3 or minus 4. It must be very, very lower than the source potential. So, this is the circuit, this is the picture which is giving you the details about the negative voltage given to the gate source terminal when the VDS is positive. So, here we know that the gate terminal is of P type. The two P type material is interconnected and it is given to the gate terminal. And if you look at the polarity of the external battery given to the gate terminal, again it is negative. So, we know that the VGS is negative and the positive P type material is given to a negative polarity, it is a reverse bias condition again. So, here VDS is positive here and VGS is negative. If it is negative, VGS is negative, then the reverse biased condition occurs here. If the reverse bias is given, the depletion region with this wider, the depletion region with this greater when you apply reverse bias. But for the smaller values of VDS, we will get the pinch off condition. So, previously VGS is equal to 0 and only VDS is given. Now, VGS is also given, but more negative value. And so, the depletion region with this wider very quickly for smaller values of VDS. This graph shows you how the VGS, negative VDS gives you the pinch off voltage for various curves. So, here this curve, the first topmost curve is for VGS is equal to 0 volt. So, where the VP present here, the pinch off voltage, it is at this point the pinch off voltage is present, and whenever VDS is equal to the pinch off voltage, the ID current is saturated. And here if you reduce this voltage, the gate source voltage, as minus 1 volt, the current flow is reduced and the pinch off happens more quickly than VGS is equal to 0 volt condition. So, when you reduce VGS as minus 1 volt, the pinch off happens before the condition, for the condition VGS equal to 0 volt. And again, if you reduce the VGS as minus 2 volt, again the pinch off happens very quickly than the previous curve. And when you look at the next curve for minus 3 volt, it is again it happens here. The pinch off happens here. It is very, very quickly than the previous three curves. And if VGS is minus 4 volt, the ID is 0. There is no flow of electrons and it becomes 0. At this point, the VGS voltage is negative enough and so the FET is turned off. So, this parabola depicts that the pinch off voltage happens very quickly for the negative VGS. If you reduce the VGS value more and more negative, the pinch off voltage happens very quickly when you compare it with the other curves and for smaller values of VDS also. And when you look at this graph, it shows you that from 0 to the pinch off voltage, this region is said to be ohmic region, or you can say it is a voltage controlled resistor. The JFET is a voltage controlled resistor for this ohmic region because the JFET is going to be the acting as a resistor by the applied potential. When you apply voltage VGS, so this is the value of the resistance which varies according to the gate source voltage and the drain source voltage. And from this point, this pinch off voltage, after the pinch off voltage, when you look at this graph, it is the saturation region, or you can say that it is a constant current region, or it is a linear region. At this region, the FET can be used as an used for amplification. So, the resistance of the channel, the resistance effect of the channel can be determined by RD equal to R naught by 1 minus VGS by VP the whole square, where the R naught is the resistance with VGS equal to 0. When VGS is equal to 0, what is the resistance? That is R naught, and RD is the resistance at a particular level of VGS. For an n channel JFET with R naught equal to 10 kilo ohms with VGS 0 and the pinch off voltage minus 6 volt, which results in 40 kilo ohms at VGS is equal to minus 3 volt. So, these are the modes of FETs. We know that what are the different types of modes. It is a common source, common drain and common gate. If it is common source, then the source terminal is common to other two terminals. Gate is the input terminal and drain is the output terminal. Here it has a high input impedance and good voltage amplification. The output is 180 degree out of phase with the input in common source. And for common gate configuration, gate is common to the source and drain terminal. The input is given to the source and output is taken across the gate and drain and gate. And it has low input impedance but high output impedance. It is used in impedance matching circuits where a low input impedance needs to be matched to a high output impedance. The output is in phase with the input in the circuit. And next one is the common drain configuration, where drain is common to both the input and output side. The input is given to the gate and output is taken across the source and ground. It is a source follower. It has high input impedance and a low output impedance. It has nearly unity voltage gain. The output is in phase with the input. So, in this lecture, we have seen the construction and the VI characteristics of junction field effect transistor. In VI characteristics, we have seen what is ohmic region, what is a pinch off voltage and saturation current or current source. And we have seen the different types of modes of JFET as common source, common gate and common drain. Questions: list the similarities and differences between BJT and FET. What is variable controlled resistor? What happens to the drain current when pinch off condition occurs? And what is the current source? These are the references. Thank you.